Good evening. Yeah, so I'm the outsider performance for today. Just got into New Orleans yesterday and I'm here on a boys trip with a bunch of my friends. I think they're somewhere over here. Hey guys. So yeah, I've just come in from Amsterdam and that's where I live right now. And Amsterdam is actually a city where a lot of, you know, people tend to go there and party. And I've come all the way from Amsterdam here to New Orleans because back in Amsterdam, I live with my wife. and the thing is, see, I mean, I am happily married. Just that she's happy, I'm married. And it's good to be here with these guys, you know, because I know these guys from school. We've been to school back in India, and I'm glad I'm here with them here in New Orleans and not partying in India. Because in India, it's really tough to have, you know, a good time out with guys. Because the closest you can get to, say, a strip club is something called a dance bar, okay? Because you guys know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Because a dance bar is basically a place where you have women fully clothed dancing in front of you to a Bollywood song. And in case you would pay them, what they would do is dance right in front of you to a song of your choice. That's what it is. So I'm really glad we're here. But yeah, we just got here yesterday. We get to see what New Orleans is going to offer. But yeah, I'm glad I'm here with these guys, you know, because these are the guys that I've grown up with, and they've left a, you know, they left a mark on me. And some even physical, like this thing, like this scar on my nose, which is basically skin from my ear that's landed up over here, which happened as a result of a drunken driving accident that I had when I was out once drinking with these guys. And I can never forget that day because basically we were out drinking and I had this accident on the way back and I had to be rushed to the hospital. And when I was at the hospital, one of my friends, in fact the guy whose birthday it was, he was so drunk that he started throwing up right in the garden which was in the center of this hospital. And when he was doing that, the nurse comes running up to him and she says, you know, you can't do this, this is a hospital. And then he looks at her and says, but I can't handle the sight of blood. Had nothing to do with blood, he was just drunk. and then I was in this room where this doctor is stitching up my nose. And I can actually see him, you know, taking the needle through like this. And as he was doing that, somewhere in the middle, it just suddenly dawned on me that I'm conscious and I can see him do this. So then I ask him, I'm like, have you given me some kind of an anesthesia or something? And then he says, you know what, you don't need any anesthesia, you're so drunk you can't feel the pain. And then, so then he's doing this, I can see him do this, and that's when I get a call. I pick it up and I answer, and it's actually the dad of one of my friends who's there in that group. And he starts shouting at me saying, you know, where is my son? He was supposed to be home an hour ago. And, I'm trying to tell him, just hang on, I can't talk to your son right now because I'm literally tied up right now. So that actually happened back then, and right now I'm in Netherlands, you know, and you guys might know about this phrase, being Dutch. These guys really live it over there because they split everything, you know, right down to the last cent. It doesn't matter even if you're on a date, they would split the bill even then. In fact, they would even split the bill if you go for a wedding. You know, so there's no concept of going for a wedding and expecting a free meal over there because they will actually ask you to pay for it just to attend the wedding. It's pretty crazy over there. But yeah, I am having a good time over there, and but you know, some of the things are pretty crazy over there as well. Because I remember this time when I just reached Netherlands, I moved there about 3 years back for work, and it was my first week over there, and I was really trying to fit in, you know. So I bought a bike, just like every other person in Netherlands. I had this cycle to take me to work, and because it used to be really cold, I got this mask as well. I mean, it's sort of a cap that would cover your whole face and just leave space for the eyes. So there I was one day on the bike wearing this mask and, you know, on the bike on the way to office. And suddenly this car comes screeching in front of me and stops. And two big guys get off and start walking towards me. Now I've seen this scene many times in movies, right? So I thought I'm getting mugged. But the only, you know, funny part was, why I was just wondering, why are there two well-dressed guys trying to mug one guy on a bike? But then I was new to Netherlands, so I thought this is how mugging works in Netherlands. But then it turned out they were just cops, and they felt very suspicious that I was wearing this cap. And, you know, they come up to me and they say, you can't wear a cap like this because this is a ski mask. And I tell them, you know, I had no idea this was a ski mask because I've never been skiing in my life. In fact, I've never even seen snow in my life. I just flew from India. So anyway, they let me off with a warning and they say I can't wear something like this. And it turned out that I seem to always get into trouble with cops, you know, because there was the last time I was here in the US, in fact, it was about 20 years back, but it was the first time I've ever gone out of India. So I was here and I was so excited to see all these tall high rises over here, and I've never seen buildings like that. So just picture this, okay, a brown skinned guy like me, wearing a cap, wearing a scarf, going about taking photos of all the buildings around. Yeah, so I just had it coming, you know, so before I knew it, there was a cop who just, you know, descended on me and he started asking me for my ID and things like that. So yeah, so that's been my trip with cops, and that's been my, you know, that's how my trips to the US have been. But I'm really looking forward to the time over here this time with all these guys, looking forward to party with you, and thank you all for your time. Thank you.